My name is Joan Duda from the University of Birmingham in the United Kingdom, and I am the president of the European College of Sports Science. It's a pleasure for me to introduce this very important session today. GSSI has been our platinum partner. We've had a partnership for, I think, 8 years now, and have worked together very closely. I think what's very important about ECSS and GSSI is that we share many missions together, many aims and aspirations for the larger field. One of those is to always promote evidence-based practice, to have our research be as innovative as possible, and to keep pushing the boundaries to try to enhance people's health and well-being. The other is to empower the young scientists. And I think what happened this afternoon with the GSSI Nutrition Award presentations exemplifies that aspect within our few days together here in Prague. And of course, at the end of our few days, we have our Young Investigator Award of ECSS that also exemplifies this thrust. So with no further ado, we'll get right into it. It's my pleasure to turn the mic over to a good colleague and a friend over many years, Professor James Carter, who is director of GSSI. Okay.
Good evening. Joan alluded to it, but Joan and I have known each other for quite a few years. I think 1999, give or take, was probably the first time me as a student, Joan as a even then a distinguished member of the academic community. And it's been it's a privilege and an honor to share the stage tonight. And Joan, congratulations on your 2 years in role. You, I think your predecessor Tim did some great work, and you've continued that. So congratulations, and wishing Eric all the very best for the 2 years that that follow. I really hope and expect to be a close collaborator and partner in those years ahead. Also, as Joan said, one of the synergies between the Gatorade Sports Science Institute and ECSS is the advancement and the support of future scientists. It's something that we at GSSI hold close to our heart, and I think these awards are evidence of that. So we have two awards. The first of which is our travel awards, which are offered to young scholars from outside of Europe to attend the annual congress and highlight their work in the field of sports nutrition. We have three winners this year. So their names and their areas of work are captured in this huge screen behind me, and I'm on TV, which is bloody great. So living the dream. So what I'd like to do is just announce the names. You can obviously read them, and then I'd like to receive them on the stage to present a small plaque, and then we'll have a quick photo, and then we'll move through to the next set of awards. So please join me in congratulating Dominique Kondo, Alana McKay, and Sarah Akawa. Come on, come on, up you come. On that white line. Oh,
okay.
Dominique, excellent. Congratulations. Elana, congratulations. Sarah, congratulations. Right, we'll join Joan on this white line. And then our second award is the Sports Nutrition Award. And this year we had a record intake of 97 abstracts, which is fantastic. It's fantastic right up until the point that I opened my ECSS account and realized we had 97 and not the 37 that I was expecting. So it's a good problem to have, but I think that's just evidence of hopefully the growing importance and recognition of sports nutrition around the world. And what we did with our approach is that we have a three-judge panel who scrutinize all of the 97 abstracts. So together with myself, we had Professor Graham Close and Dr. Ben Wall. And where there was conflicts of interest, they didn't review those abstracts, and we brought in additional judges, or at least the college brought in additional judges. And then we down-selected to normally a top five. This year was a top six because we couldn't separate them. And the six finalists presented their work earlier this afternoon in front of a new judging panel. So we had Professor Stephen Seiler, Professor Luke Van Loon, and Dr. Shona Housen, who were asking the questions and then also coming together at the end. So here we have the six finalists, and this award is recognizing innovative and high-quality research presented, obviously, at this year's Congress, and it must be high impact with practical outcomes that help advance sports nutrition science for sports health professionals and athletes. And so I'll announce the equal fourth place first, if those three can come to the front of the stage here, and we'll do that photo again. And then we'll move into the rest of the placings. So in equal fourth place, we have Marcus Hannon, Sarah Akawa, and Hani Kopechi. If they can please come forward, thank you. Okay, and then I'm going to change the rules here, and I'm going to announce the third, second, and first place, and ask them all to come at the stage at the same time. Otherwise, we'll be back and forth with the photos. So, in third place was Mark Fell with work on exogenous carbohydrate oxidation during endurance exercise and its impact on subsequent intramuscular substrate oxidation. Congratulations, Mark. And then in second place, with his work on mycoprotein and muscle protein synthesis in comparison to milk protein, was Alistair Montaigne. Which leaves only one. And so in first place, with some excellent work on acute carnosine and anserine supplementation during high-intensity exercise, was Laura Blancquaert. So please, all of you, all three, come to the stage, and we'll have that photo, but tremendously well done. So that just leads me to thank you all for coming and supporting these awards. We're at the start, day one of an excellent three and a half days. This event, this Congress, is really about the science and the people, and you make, you know, you make it the people. So enjoy yourselves, be safe, and I look forward to meeting many of you down the road. Thank you very much.